Hello student, today I am going to discuss friction. What is friction? When a body moves or tends to move over a surface, an opposing force is developed in between the surface of contact is called friction or frictional force. Now you see the diagram, a block is a force, at the applied force, this block is slides towards right. So when the block is slides over the surface, then a frictional force is developed in the opposite direction of the motion of the block. So an opposing force is developed when the block is slides, an opposing force is developed in the opposite direction, that is called friction or frictional force. Now, what is static friction? Static friction, the force of friction which comes into play between the surface of two bodies before the body starts moving is called static friction. So this is the static friction, this is the force at which surface of two bodies before the body starts moving, before sliding, what is the force acting? That is called static friction. So it depends on the nature of surface of two bodies in on contact. So this static friction, which is denoted by Fs, is directly referring to the normal reaction. R represents reaction. R is reaction. You see, the weight of the body acting vertically downwards, normal reaction acting upwards, that is R. So Fs, any property, right, if you write equal, you have to write mu suffix s, mu s R. So mu s is called, this is the property constant, mu s is called coefficient of static friction, where mu s is called coefficient of static friction. Same as kinetic friction, the force of friction which comes into play between the surface of contact of two bodies when one surface is in motion, static motion, over the other surface is called kinetic friction. So kinetic friction, so when the body, you see, when this body is in motion, body is moving over the other surface. So one surface at rest, another surface moving, then whatever opposing force is developed, that is called kinetic friction. So kinetic friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. So kinetic friction denoted by Fk, directly proportional to the normal reaction R. So Fk equal to mu R. Where the proportional constant mu k, where mu k is called coefficient of kinetic friction. Now limiting friction. So limiting friction, the maximum value of the force of friction which comes into play before a body just begins to slide over the surface of another body is called limiting friction. To understand limiting friction, you see the diagram. So this is the applied force. When force is applying, so the frictional force in the opposite direction increasing as the increasing the applied force. So a stress will come, the block starts moves, or the block just starts sliding. Whatever be the maximum force acting in the opposite direction just before sliding the body block or body, that is called limiting friction. Same way, limiting friction F is directly related to the normal reaction. So F equal to mu R. So mu is called same coefficient of limiting friction, where mu is called coefficient of limiting friction. That is mu equal to, you can write F by R. Now you know force equal to F equal to ma, normal reaction just now you got R equal to mg. So frictional force F equal to mu R. Since R equal to mg, so frictional force F equal to mu mg. Whenever you write frictional force, always you have to remember F equal to mu mg. This is frictional force. If you compare this equation number 1 and equation number 2, then F equal to ma equal to mu mg. Mm cancel. So A equal to mu g. So acceleration is the product of coefficient of friction and acceleration due to gravity. Now I'll discuss loss of friction. Loss of friction number 1, the frictional force depends upon the nature of the two surface in contact, their state of roughness. The frictional force depends upon the nature of the two surface in contact and their state of roughness. Number 2, frictional force always acts parallel to the surface in contact and in a direction in opposite to motion. Number 3, magnitude of frictional force is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Normal reaction between the two surfaces in contact. And number four, frictional force is independent of the area of contact of the two surfaces. So you see, laws of friction. First one, the frictional force depends upon the nature of the two surfaces in contact and their state of roughness. When one body slides off another body, then the frictional force depends upon smoothness of the surface in contact, means smoothness in between the surface in contact, number one. Number two, frictional force always acts parallel to the surface in contact. Frictional force always acts parallel to the surface in contact in the opposite direction. Number three, third law, the magnitude of frictional force is always proportional to the normal reaction. That is, you know, F is proportional to, if you see here, this body, this is the block, weight is mg, normal reaction R, frictional force, applied force, this direction, and frictional force develop in the opposite direction. So this frictional force is acts parallel to the surface in contact, and this normal reaction, frictional force is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Keep in mind, this is very important. Frictional force always act proportional to, sorry, frictional force is directly proportional to the normal reaction. And frictional force is independent of the area. It does not depend upon the area. Thank you.